Vijay, thanks so much for your time.
Thank you so much. I was waiting to come on Bloomberg Quint and these iPhone cameras.
We're glad we've caught your attention.
This media company is up to the digital age.
Are we up to your standards?
Not a standard. I would say digital age.
Oh, great. That's a fabulous age compliment to start with. Vijay, Payments Bank, you finally got a product out, or at least the contours of a product out. But you launched with a 4% flat interest rate. No. That's a bit disappointing.
I think what we are trying to do is that we are trying to build a long-term bank. And we've learned that we, instead of being frivolous first, we can probably adjust it. 4% is a lower amount. But at the same point of time, the way our complete product will fold out, you will like it. It'll be more than 4% then.
What is the value proposition? If I was a customer, why would I open a Paytm Payments Bank account right now?
Let me talk product language first and then tell you what it is.
Okay.
The theory of a minimum viable product in technology parlance is called that you should build small complete products, and they are addressing some small subset of customers. So today's our payment bank product, incidentally, is meant for people who have Paytm wallets, will get a bank account, and now they can pay at the places where Paytm wallet is not accepted. For example, like you can buy at Flipkart, Amazon, and you can book Ola, not just Uber. So if you notice, we are trying to be very narrow-minded when it comes to how we are launching segment of the customer. So you and I use Paytm wallet, we book Uber, but we can't book Ola using Paytm wallet. But now it is a bank account, it has a debit card, virtual debit card, it can work out there. So step one is that. Step two is that we will believe that we'll offer you incredible money transfer, incoming, outgoing, and then returns on that. And third will be when we add the wealth management product to that. And fourth will be that we add additional services. So we take one product at a time and complete in themselves, and then addressing a smaller set. Okay. Day one, you can't reach 100. You reach first. It's sort of a journey of a million mile by 1 inch at a time.
Okay. So two, three questions. So one, remember we had talked in about September, October, and you had said this money market concept. It sounded exciting. Basically, you know, just fungible money market in and out.
Absolutely.
That hasn't happened.
Well, I think all products of the bank, whether there is savings or wealth management product, we request regulator to approve. So it's right now there is a lot of different payment banks are taking differently when it comes to the balance of more than 1 lakh rupees. So a central bank is expected to come out with some understanding how should a bank account of a customer in a payment bank, if the balance goes more than 1 lakh, what happens to that amount? Should it be kept in fungible, like wealth management fund that we talked about, or should it be kept in a suspense account and shared, or should it bear interest, or what? Now, elements like these, ones that get clear, we'll also add a wealth management product there.
But you can't take more than 1 lakh, right?
That's what I'm saying, that if, let's say, you got, let's say, some reimbursement came, or some loan you got which was 1.5 lakh and it was coming in this account. You got some edge benefit and then you got DBT which just crossed 1 lakh. So there has to be a case handling of what happens more than 1 lakh. Even if that is not what our primary target is, that will define how our wealth management product will go. Today, by the way, we have an incredible wealth management product in gold.
I'll come to that, but I'm not done with the payments bank. Okay, so at 4%, what is your net interest margin working out to, everything considered? Are you working with a...
Let me tell you, our payment bank will remain net positive and it'll still have 500 million customers. Let's just get these two things sorted.
Where are the 500 million customers coming from?
In this country, our 500 million customers will come from the place. So our bank starts from bottom up. Traditional banks, obviously, they want the richest customer, and then they want the customers where the optimum stops, and then they stop needing that customer onwards. But our bank starts from the other way around, and it gets happiest when you get a higher value customer, but it is totally happy with a very low value customer. For us, the wealth management customer is the one who has an annual 10,000 rupees.
But how will you get those customers, Vijay? I mean, I don't mean to pitch you against your competitors, but an Airtel is already out there in that market,
Post,
right?
India Post is
out there in the market. How are you going to go get these guys?
Somewhere, one should know that Paytm has a far more bigger distribution than a telco has. We are in more places than telco is.
But your customers, your current wallet customers would be largely tier 1, tier 2 customers?
No. Actually, majority stands for like 60%+ is tier 3 onward. Okay, our distribution is, so two things here clarifying, I got it what you are coming from. One, telcos have recharge distributions, which is amazingly well penetrated across nook and corner of the country. And then there are sub-distributor and so on. So that's a couple of hundred thousand. I think the best guy will have 700,000, 800,000 or maybe even million and so on. While if I was to map that to our distribution, we have more than 5 million active merchants. And certain subset of that will become our bank BCs and agents and so on and so forth. So we believe we are not second to none. We are today second to none when it comes to distribution itself as a piece. We are there at a border of India from Pakistan side. We are there at the border of India from China side. And we are there at a center of India when you look at the middle India and central India. So distribution. The customer base. Customer base wise, I think we've been very lucky. In demonetization days, I had shown a public slide where we were showing that, let me tell you the transaction stat, which is really beautiful, and we were totally pleasantly surprised by this. Towns which are less than 100,000 are the one that we have a public data of. So these accounted for in this August, September of last year, about 1.5 to 2% of our total transaction. In January, those were accounting for 15 to 20% transaction when our transaction itself has combined grown 5-7 times. Mm-hmm. So we're talking about a massive large transaction customer base in tier 3, tier 6, that width.
Okay.
So that is what our customer base is.
Okay. And what internally, what percentage of your wallet customers do you think will convert, or what number will you be happy with?
I think, remember that wallet is getting a reset in this country because the KYC has sort of a new requirement come, and we feel ourselves lucky that we just got the new rope of bank account. So cost of customer acquisition will include KYC there. Now, the customer for wallet is effectively going to be reacquired. Because if I was to trust the draft guideline that has come, it actually says that if a customer is not KYC, in 2 months that person will expire, and the same customer cannot be reacquired to non-KYC.
Do you know if those guidelines are getting finalized?
I'm saying that if that gets done, okay, that is what will become.
Okay.
We are getting ready for the worst, so that is what we are saying. What we are saying is that we want to acquire everybody again, and we, just like telecom operators are acquiring in a way, KYC verification is a reacquisition, if you will, at least at a cost of verification level. So that's what we are all. So I think what India is going to see in next 3 years, 2-3 years, is 1 billion KYC happening in this country. That's like minimum, because telco plus bank combined will be there.
Are you going to link it largely to Aadhaar? Are you also going to?
We are the champions of Aadhaar. We believe this is a great ID because it is biometric. So it dedupes the person really legitimately. And remember that there is anti-money laundering and all sorts of other things that get settled if you take care of Aadhaar. While there are a lot of concerns that I read on Twitter about Aadhaar, but at the same time, we are total believer of Aadhaar, that identity is better by an Aadhaar identification versus, let's say, a driving license or a ration card.
But the economics, so if you move away from wallet and move towards payment bank, That's the shift. The economics of the payment bank are very different from the economics of the wallet, right?
So you're right. And in fact, what I want to tell you here is that in payments bank, you should see what we did in the wallet. By the way, I remember there was a very public statement on how we were loss making of plus of 1500 crores. I don't even remember the number, but that number was quoted.
What is the number now? You can tell me the number now.
I actually don't remember the perfect number as much it was quoted. But at the same point, what I want to tell you here is, in last 2 years, we have spent more than $600 million. That's more than $500 million only on payments by one company in this country. And that's a massive large amount. So our wallet business, which is effectively, we treat it as a payments business. We don't call wallet, it's just another payment option there. Obviously, honest transactions are wallet transactions, office transactions are using all other elements like UPI cards, net banking, and so on. So our payments business, we spent $600 million in the last 2 years. So that is what gets us to become what we are as a size today. Payment bank, we're talking about 10,000 crore of investment, like at least three times of that investment.
And what's the profitability roadmap? What is the
When I say investment, it just simply means we're ready to spend without earning that money.
So for how many years can you do that? You've got big investors, I'm sure they're asking you.
With the kind of spend net cost that we're looking at, in a year, we are not, $200 million of losses, if you will, to say that. I mean, net-net, we are talking that level
at
number. At a combined company level, combined of cash flow level. Okay. And I'm talking cash flow, I'm not talking P&L math.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking cash flow. I think we are good with 5-6 years.
You're good with 5-6 years. Yeah, actually, that kind of losses.
Yeah, I mean, let's just be clear about it. We got into this business with the clarity that for 5-6 years, we will try to create a large market. And we have an ambition that by 2020, we'll have 500 million accounts. So 2020, 500 million account. We definitely will have 2 years runway even after that for the spend that we have a plan of.
So when does the payment bank break even if everything goes as per plan?
I think payment bank is lucky. It has a rich parent. Because parents can spend a lot of other math and which gets benefit to the customer at payment bank. So payment bank could get break even much sooner. Much sooner stands for less than 3 years. Parent might take even more than 3 years. And actually at a parent level, we are clear about it that it is not a break even of a total cost. We're looking at break even of COGS, marketing, funding cost, everything else. But of the technology cost. Technology is people that we employ or technology that we buy. So our belief is that we should have a long haul investment on technology and extreme aggressive cost savings and cost attention to everything else beyond technology. We want to take a bet that technology is an infrastructure that we have to build in this country. Whether it means that we have to distribute technology, whether it means we have to build technology part one, part two, part three, for example, you saw traditionally companies have been wallet for ages. And we launched corporate benefit program on wallet. It just became another interesting conversation and I saw many doing it, which is just the way it should be. And RBI also made digital transactions possible there. So our understanding is that we are building technology infrastructure and fabric for our country and we are the champions of that by driving it at 0% transactions and fee, and that is what our belief is. Once we do that, the dividends of this will come after 5 and 10 years. So our view of this country is that for 5 years we are builders, for 5 years onward we'll continue to build few more things, but our pieces will start to show up. Right now it is a pre-early stage. It's like Jeff Bezos saying, it's still the day one.
Vijay, you know, one question on payment banks. Obviously, you know, you are convinced of the model, but I'll tell you why I'm re-asking this question. Because when the payment bank was first mooted, the banking sector was very different. Today, you've had a massive success of Jan Dhan. You have a massive drive from the government to get all of these accounts to be Aadhaar linked. And every bank is offering.
And every telecom operator nearly will acquire a customer for their own banks.
Yeah.
Truth of the matter is that there is a customer acquisition of a bank which is happening in this country at a very different scale.
Yeah, so then why, how is a payment bank that relevant anymore?
I think it is not the payment bank that will be called less relevant or more. What I should treat it is that what will be more relevant is what customers are asking for. Like you know, in the wallet space or the payment space, it doesn't mean that we were sitting in the middle of less competition. Mm. We actually also, I believe that had traditional payment methods and there was no need of wallet. Actually, people have not yet understood why wallet is needed. So that is why they first of all said there was no need of wallet. Now they are saying death of wallet. But by the way, when did you believe there was a need of wallet? So okay, did you ever focus on this product so that you're, because you couldn't control, you couldn't control the narrative. So you said there will be a death of wallet. Oh, wow. I mean, I have a quote from Yogi Berra on this. Death of, news of my death are overstated.
Okay. So you're saying news of payment banks being redundant is overstated. That's what you're telling me.
Absolutely. And there is no reason. I mean, the thing that payment bank gets, let's just remember, the only thing payment bank doesn't get is a 1 lakh rupee restriction and using that capital for lending. Hmm. I'm very proud of the second, by the way, because we want to be the most secure and safest bank in this country. We nearly are that thanks to the regulation.
Yeah, that's because of regulation.
I use the word thanks to the regulation. I mean, if you want to be the banker in the new world as we are seeing today and everywhere, whether you see India, whether you see Asia, whether you see rest of the world, the label you want is the safest.
Yeah.
And luckily,
but also money making, also profitable.
And I want to put the second element here, which is that if you believe that lending is a money making, then it is also an assumption that there is only one business model of the customer's money. I mean, this is not true. You should make money when the economic activity happens, and that economic activity happens when customers are not just paying, customers are doing many other things. We make money like 10% when you buy bus ticket. And what do you do with your bank money? You probably buy bus ticket, summer ticket, flight ticket, and so on. And we actually make high margin. Paytm, incidentally, as a payments business, is plus 4.5% gross contribution margin company. Now, remember, it's a payment company. Payment companies fundamentally should not be logically more than one or few more percent profitable or contribution net contribution businesses, but ours is 4% plus. And why is that? Because we learned that, look, technology does a very interesting thing. If you think Amazon is a retailer, you're missing the point. Amazon does not make money when you buy from one seller. Amazon makes money when seller keeps this item in FBA. It's a logistics company than a retailing company. A retailing company fights a logistics company. Technology integrates it. Customers flock on a logistics company's revenue model as a consumer retailer. Wow, that's amazing. And that's exactly the interesting thing about the technology businesses. People think they're fighting a business of Dash while the other company is smiling because they're building something totally Dash.
Okay, you're clearly there. Vijay, before we let you go, I want to talk about this digital gold. Very interesting.
Yeah.
What is, why did that idea come to your mind and how is it done? It's been on for about a month and a half.
Yeah, that's right.
How is it doing and where did the idea come from?
So if we were to see the number of users and the gold that we have, we would be probably the largest jeweler who has sold.
You said that earlier, but how are you saying
that? By the weekend.
That?
Because we sold in a day gold to like tens of thousands. I mean, that was like in a shop.
You have more customers than Tanishq.
That's what I was saying.
Really?
That is what we kind of do the math of. Okay. That, we are not largest by the dollar or the kgs. We are largest by the number of customers. Because people can buy 10 rupees and 50 rupees, 100 rupees, and they're learning about this, and then you become larger than that. Now, the very fundamental idea of digital gold came because we wanted to build a wealth management for masses. Like, you just heard the number, 500 million. Can I sell, let's say, even if I was to build a money market product, or even if we were to build an incredible mutual fund product, can we sell it to more than 100 million people? We just can't. I mean, in this country, not more than 1 million people trade, and not more than 2-3 million people probably be the customers of mutual funds, and add a couple of more, that's it, the market is. So the wealth management, if we were to bring to our customers, like an auto rickshaw wala or a chai wala, that person learns and loves gold. So that is why our wealth management gold standard, truest gold standard of wealth management, is only done by Paytm Payments Bank.
But people understand it, because at the end of the day, you're linked to gold prices. Tomorrow, there's a sudden crash in gold prices. You'll have people coming in saying that Paytm ne mera paisa
khatam kar diya. Gold ne mera paisa khatam kar diya.
But so you have to explain that to
absolutely.
Them.
Absolutely. It is gold, which is you're delivering at your home. And incidentally, 67% of people have not got gold delivered. They're keeping it. And they don't need to sell for tens of years. This is a gold kept in a vault owned by MMTC PAMP. And that is like a locker free, comes free with it. I mean, just let's understand, if you want to be the, how should we do the wealth management actually? I mean, my theory are only two. One is the saving account / FD account, which is like a literally cash liquid. Yes.
Okay, so what is the AUM under your gold, this thing right now? Is AUM the right way to measure it?
Perfect, perfect. Number of kgs, AUM, that is. I think, I mean, I want to tell you one thing today. For the bank, or for our wealth management products, we'll give numbers literally annually. Okay. Because what we want to learn is that it's sort of in between insights or excites, whichever way. And like you said, there is always the news. So we want to keep this news like an annual news. Okay. Right now, it's in tens of kgs, not large.
Okay. And this is all backed by physical gold.
It's all not just backed by, each one of them who has more than 1 gram can ask for delivery. Yes, it is backed and ready to be delivered. It is 24 karat.
Risk on this gold, because again, it's
we don't have to manage
price,
the risk,
right?
Because we are the sellers.
So it's just a pass through.
It's just a pass through. We are a margin makers. When you buy or sell gold, we make margin.
Okay, got that. Vijay, I think I'll end the conversation there. Thank you so much. Always
Thank
a
you.
Pleasure speaking
Thank
to you.
You.
Thanks.
Thank you.